Friends, welcome back to Guaro Tutorials. This is the first video in the series of photosynthesis. So, we'll be focusing on the history of photosynthesis. It basically takes place in the leaf and the stem. Photosynthesis is a physicochemical process during which the carbon dioxide is reduced to carbohydrates, and for this particular reaction, the presence of light is very, very significant. Photosynthesis is basically the process which is referred to as anabolic, or you can call it as a constructive process, because the simpler products are converted into complex form. The reaction of photosynthesis can be summed up as 6 molecules of carbon dioxide combining with 12 molecules of water, for which the presence of light and chlorophyll is very evident. We find the product formed as glucose along with 6 molecules of oxygen and 6 molecules of water. See, the substance are simpler, the reactant are simpler, whereas the product is complex. Hence, it is called as an anabolic process. Let us now try to understand the history of photosynthesis. The major emphasis would be paid on this in the video. The first person that we are going to talk about is Joseph Priestley, and he conducted a very simple experiment which was referred to as Bell Jar experiment. The experiment included placing a mice and a candle in an inverted bell jar, and it was found that both the candle and the mice used up the air which was present inside the jar. Later on, it was found that the mice as well as the candle, they had certain problems. That is, the mice died and the candle extinguished. This compelled Priestley to think what could be the probable reason for this. And he concluded that both the mice and the candle would have used up the air and turned it into a foul air. This foul air was called as phlogiston. In a similar set of experiment, he took mice, candle and a plant this time, an inverted bell jar. This time it was found that introduction of the mint plant, the plant he took was a mint plant. He found that introduction of the mint plant helped the mice to survive longer, as well as the candle also did not extinguish. Now he was compelled to conclude that the mint plant which was introduced would have purified the air which was earlier foul. This purified air was referred to as dephlogiston air. The another scientist that we are going to talk now about is Jan Ingenhousz. His experiment was conducted on aquatic plants. What did he do was, he took a flask in which he put nutrient along with the aquatic plant and covered it with cotton plug. It was found that during the dark, no bubbles were produced around the leaves. But if the same setup was introduced or placed in the daylight before a sun, it was found that on the surface of the leaf, around the leaf, bubbles were produced. So, in the light reaction, bubbles were produced. During the light, it was observed that bubbles were produced around the leaf, and later on it was found that bubbles were of oxygen. Thereby, Ingenhousz concluded that green parts of the plant are necessary for releasing oxygen. The third scientist was Julian Von Sachs. In 1854, Julius Von Sachs observed that green substance, which are now referred to as chlorophyll, are localized in a specialized body called as chloroplast. He also observed and concluded that the green substances are the ones which are responsible for production of glucose, and the glucose is converted and stored in the form of starch. Starch is stored food in case of plant. Another scientist to take into consideration was T.W. Engelmann. He worked on an experiment called as action spectrum of photosynthesis. In the test tube, he took the alga called as cladophora and a suspension of aerobic bacteria and placed it before prism. We do know the prism would split the light into its constituent color, which is vibrio. It was found that when the prism had split the light into its constituent color, the aerobic bacteria were found mainly aligning in the zone of blue light and red light. So Engelmann concluded that photosynthesis takes place in blue and the red light. By the middle of the 19th century, it was established that the carbon dioxide and water combine in presence of light to form a carbohydrate and oxygen. But the exact reaction was not known, and this was called as empirical equation, the one which you can see now. It was the effort of Cornelius von Niels which laid the foundation of the detailed study of photosynthesis. He worked on purple-green bacteria. He observed that hydrogen from a suitable oxidizing compound can reduce the carbon dioxide into carbohydrate, and again, presence of light is very essential. The reaction was summed up as 2H2A plus carbon dioxide in presence of light would give 2A plus carbohydrate plus water. It was found that when H2S, which is hydrogen sulfide, was used instead of water, sulfur was produced but not oxygen. This was a very significant impression. This inferred that oxygen is released from water and not from carbon dioxide. So that is it, guys. I hope you would have liked the video. If that's the case, please hit the like button. You can also share the video with your friends as much as you want. And do subscribe to my channel. May God bless you all. Thank you very much.